Hello again, new tutorial, this time about the if logic action. The idea would be to use the if logic action to try and find out if the login was successful in the pet store before we actually continue and do the rest. In general, it's a good idea to put in place such mechanism because you want to find out if the first step is okay before you go on to the next ones instead of generating errors because the login was incorrect. So there are several ways we can do that, but I want specifically to use the if logic action. We'll have a look at the other ones later on. But first, let's try to understand what makes a successful or unsuccessful login on the pet store. If we go back there, let's try first with a successful login. Here we can see when we sign in, we have a welcome message in the page, which is basically telling us that it's okay. So that's one way we could find out if the login was correct here using this welcome message. Of course, if you prefer, you can also do it the opposite way. You can try an incorrect login and see what's going on. And here when we do that, we see we have an invalid username or password. So either way are fine for the login here. But we're going to use the welcome message because that's the most tricky one to use. So first, let's try to understand where we have this welcome message. I will use a search to understand where it comes from. I want to search in the response from the server, see where I have welcome in there. So let's search for that. So we have many different places, but let's pick up the first one. So if we look in there, the response, but we can see it's actually the welcome division here is empty, so that's not the one we're looking for. Let's search for another one here when we check the response. Again, let's search for welcome, and this time we can see that we have the welcome message we're looking for, so that's the one we want to check. Notice that at the runtime we use a different account than the text here is different. That's because the text is a username. So that's why it's also interesting to have a validation to be able to compare. We can see that we shouldn't validate for ABC or test because that can change depending on the login. So to make it easier, what I'm going to try to extract here using a regex is if I have this welcome message or not. And to do that, let's first add the regex. Then I will again search for welcome. And so I won't pick this one because if you remember, we've seen that even when we don't have the welcome message, we still have this division in the HTML here, the welcome div here. So that's not really enough to make sure that we are logged in successfully. But what I will do is I want to make sure that I have some text here surrounded by a welcome space. And after that, I want to have this exclamation mark. So if I have some text here that I can extract, that means we were logged in because there was a welcome message. It doesn't really matter what's the value here, if it's ABC or test. And that's why I'm extracting this value here. Again, not that I care about what's in there. I want to see if the extraction works or not. And a regex, when it works, will extract some value. When it doesn't, it will put the default value in there. And the default value is not found. So what I have to do now is to control if login OK will be equal to not found. And then I can decide what to do. So let's add the if logic action to do that. Let's add it right there. Although, careful, I don't want it to be inside login submit. I will roll back here. Let's call it login OK. And my condition here will be that my variable login OK, this one, and that's where we have to think a bit about it. We want to continue only when the login is working fine. So login working fine means that the value of this variable is different from not found, because not found means the welcome message was not there. So let's use the different operator, not equal. I can type not found from memory, but if you're not sure, you can go back to the regex to copy paste it. Now, there's one thing that's wrong with this if logic action, and that's usually where everybody gets it wrong. It's a bit confusing, but the way it works in JMeter, and we have to do it the way it works in JMeter because we will use JMeter in the end. So the way it works in JMeter, you have to think about dollar bracket login OK here as something that's going to be replaced with a variable value. And if we put it this way, we'll have on one side of the operator, we'll have double quotes, and on the other, we won't. So the right syntax, and that's what I wanted to show you here, the right syntax for this kind of thing is to put brackets around login OK here. And that's what I'm going to do. This way, we're comparing a string with a string. Oh, not here. Let's put it right here. There we go. Now, the other thing we have to take care of is that this if here is controlling this condition, that's fine, but it's not doing anything for now because it will apply only to what's inside it. So we have to move in there all the rest because we want to replay the rest only if the login was okay. Here, if the login is different from not found, we are going to replay what's in there. Let's try first with an incorrect login. Going back to post year data, and I will put pretty much anything in the login field. I think that shouldn't work, and we should be able to see that when we replay the script. So let's see about that. So the expected behavior here is that the if will not let us continue. We'll see what that means. But what I expect is that we will not enter in there and will not have a green dot on any of these containers because they were not replayed. We'll try after that with the correct login and see what's the difference. So the validate is initializing, it's running now. We can see that we have an orange dot here, so our login was not okay apparently. And for now it's not entered the rest. Validation is finished, you see, and we didn't go any further. Though the if worked, it stopped us from continuing. Let's try with a login that worked this time, see what's different. I will fast forward to when we have the result so that we don't have to wait. And there we can see it's running and see this time everything has been replayed. So it's working as expected. So now that's okay for this tutorial. We've had a look at how to use the if logic action. We'll go a bit further in the next tutorial by using a loop to put several things in a cart. And that should be an interesting exercise as well. So thanks for watching and see you in the next tutorial. Bye bye.